I think you will be surprised to know that I can claim very strongly, almost all of you are interested in our research in some way or other. How? Because modern day machine thinking or machine learning comes from data. Earlier years, when artificial intelligence first came into being, many people were asking me when AI started, is the future is about AI. But AI is not a matter of future. AI is there since 1956, when John McCarthy coined the term artificial intelligence. And it is almost from the inception of computers, because first high-level language program came in 1954, and McCarthy created Lisp in 1956. And since then, people were talking about how we can use computers to think like human beings, to behave like human beings, and perhaps that is the crux of artificial intelligence, where we like to reduce the gap between man and machine. And therefore, the research was that we import the faculties of human beings into the machine, whether it is physical or it is mental. If it is physical, then we want machine to see like us, and from their generative computer vision, we wanted machine to hear like us and understand what we are speaking, and that gave rise to speech recognition. Similarly, image processing and other techniques have come up, which are all parts of artificial intelligence. But another important aspect of AI was thinking or reasoning. We human beings can reason with facts, and we can derive new findings from the facts that have been given to us. How can we make our machines to behave like that? That was the research, and it is not in 50s. If you heard of Aristotle, you will know that 350 BC or so, he was talking about deductive reasoning. So it is several centuries, more than 2,000 years, that people are thinking about reasoning. But it has become very more pertinent with the advent of AI, because now we want our machines to think like human beings. So that gave us the challenge of designing a machine which will behave like human. In our childhood also we have heard of robots, and perhaps you people are also reading stories about robots. So it is like that, that is the change. But when it comes to actual problem solving, people started thinking that they can actually create a human being. You might have read about Frankenstein, where people were trying to make a human being out of electricity by charging at his body into and making it alive. So that much of imagination was there for several decades. But in 1959, when people started thinking about general problem solving, a machine which will be able to solve any problem given to it, just like a human being attempts to solve it, then people found that it is not very easy to design. So 1959, Simon and Newell, they get the concept of general problem solver. When it did not succeed, then people started thinking in a very different way. And that is called an expert system. I don't know how many of you have come across that term. Expert system means it will not solve all the problems, but it will be specialist or specializing in solving certain type of problems. So that is how it is called an expert. And we all know about human experts who are specialized only in certain domain. But the question is, to solve such problems, you need a lot of expert knowledge. How do you gather that knowledge? Right? So that was the problem, and people started knowledge representation technique, how to represent those knowledge into the computer. knowledge acquisition technique, how we acquire the knowledge from an expert. All those things were matters of research in, say, 50 years back. But the problem with experts is that experts are not always available. Say, for example, how to eradicate the dengue from Delhi. Nobody knows, there is no expert. So you cannot solve that problem through experts. Similarly, suppose one is investing in share market. How to invest it in such a way that I can make a maximum profit? There is no expert. If there were, then he would have made millions and millions of money out of it. So there is no expert. At the same time, we need to address this problem. That's from I get the knowledge. And that is where I wrote how we learn from your text. In modern times, the main resource of our knowledge is data. Say, for example, you want to decide whether to buy a particular computer or not, whether to buy a particular mobile phone or not, whether to watch a particular film or not. How do you decide? Because that, people used to ask neighbors and friends to seek their opinion. Nowadays, we don't seek any personal opinion. You open up your computer and see what people are talking about, what sort of rating people are giving. And if you see hundreds of them, and you find 80% of them are liking this, you may think of watching that particular movie or reading that particular novel, etc. So, where from we get that data? Because in this era of social media, people are writing everything. Everything is available, and so you can gather the knowledge from there. So somebody was asking me, what is the difference between machine learning and machine translation, etc. When you learn from the data, or when you make your computer learn from the data, we call it machine learning. Okay. So there was no expert. I don't know who the expert is, but I can gather the data and I can put it in such a way that my machine, my program will automatically enrich itself by gathering information from there. That is machine learning. And this we can apply to various domains. So let me talk about a few domains just to show you. Okay, so I hope all of you can see. Here are some novel applications, and you look into it, you will find that all of them need some text. Say, for example, online transaction, online booking, nowadays we are all expert in that one. But still, it needs a lot of human intervention. You want to book a hotel in, say, Bombay or London or New York, you have to sit with the computer and you have to do it. Is there a program to which you say that this is my requirement and it will automatically tell you, right, this is the right hotel for me? Similarly, recommend assisting. Just now I was talking about which book, which movie, which car to buy, which mobile phone to buy, etc. Is there a system? You give that choice and it will tell you automatically that this is your right choice. Similarly, automatic text summarizer. When so much of information is gathered, can you write a program that will summarize it and tell you, right, this is the gist of all the information that you can create, and I can explain almost all of them. Say stock price I just talked about. Automatic evaluation of stories. Nowadays, you know, whenever there is an automatic evaluation, we go by MCQs. You people are familiar. Why? Because subjective evaluation is not possible. Can you do it? What stories? Why not essays or answers? All these things. Similarly, versus disambiguation. I'll give you some example of it, so I am not elaborating on it. And disaster management. Say, for example, there is a huge flood Kerala last week. Suppose people are sending SMS from there. Can you make a system that it will automatically trigger some relief, some operation, some drone will go and it will actually capture what exactly is happening in this location? You can wait from the latitude, longitude, where from the messages are coming. If you think about it, you'll see that actually these are doable. Only thing we need to know how to process your language. Because people will be writing in different texts, different formats, using different vocabularies, using different syntax. How we shall achieve that through our program. So that is the most important thing. So let us look at this. This is how people today's people are writing. Right? Next slide. Can you actually read the second line? Right? You will find that there is only one word which is correct in English word D-U-T, but this, not a single thing is there that is standard English. I am not going into any other language. I am still working with English. And you can understand that it is very difficult because people to some extent are standardizing it, but it is still not yet standardized. And the two digits, it is already there twice in which two different meanings. First time it is CO, and second time it is CWO. How do we do it? With our intellect, with our understanding, how will the machine do it? How can make your machine learn this human ways of communicating in today's world? So in 2006, Professor Singh told me, Niladri, you have to build a system someday where you will be able to understand this, because soon students will be writing their answers in this language and you will have to understand that you can't say, no, this is not correct language. Let me now give you some example of machine translation. Somebody was asking me, what is the difference between machine learning and machine translation? So translation is the activity. Given one sentence in one language, you try to rewrite the sentence in another language. And obviously that needs a lot of knowledge. I am not naming, but it is one of the most popular online translator available. I know all of you are must be using this thing. So I did the experiment yesterday night with six different sentences and you see the outcome. Next slide. So the fan is on. It says Sushan Shak Chalu hai. Okay? You understand? What very confused. This is Watson's identification. He could not make the sense of the word fan. Next. She's in tears. Who also may have. Day before yesterday, your most popular translator is translating like this. He ran into a trouble while Lucidus may have. That too. I am doing it in Hindi because of all the 23 scheduled Indian languages as of the 8th schedule. This is the one Hindi where maximum amount of data is available. My daughter is apple of my eye. Of course, you can guess now. Maybe, maybe, maybe I'm going to say that. Right? I am looking for a game of it. I did not expect it to. One more example. The shopkeeper ran out of vegetables and put on that stuff you say Bahar. So when it comes to language understanding, now you understand where we are. We did not understand the English at all. But because it learned from human-generated sentences, it could construct sentences which are grammatically correct. So it was trying to learn the syntax of the sentence it could not capture the semantics, the sense that it is carrying. Therefore, when we talk about modern day machine learning, at least I have been working for 25 years with language and how machines can understand language. And of course, you can see that this is the state of the art. Okay, now let me talk about semantics. I have given you 6 different sentences. All of them have same identical structure. But if you look at the semantics of it, you may say the translation of them, many of them will be very similar, that is true. But suppose I am designing a question and answering system, and I am telling you with whom he is taking the rice, or with how is the rice, what is the quality of the rice, you can understand that you have to get the semantics of it to understand. But the same similar sentences, each one is conveying with sense. Okay, so I'll stop with one more example. That is one challenging problem. Okay, our aim is to categorize such type of complaints. We human beings write these things. So this is the type of complaints. I have thousands of such complaints. Our job is to categorize this thing. Which one will go to the local office, which one will go to the central office, which one we need some training, etc. And if you look at it, I have highlighted with others, but I don't know if all of you can see, you'll find that there are many grammatical mistakes here. But we can understand. Say, for example, this type of service is not acceptable from a renowned service provided as yours. You can see that. Again, this is ill, ill, which is a valid English word, but the person meant is I will. Right? Without that apostrophe, it has a complete different sense. So, how do we do it? It is not simple. I am working on this problem. I can give you many such problems so that you can understand the utility of learning from your language that you need to develop so that our machines can behave like a human being. That is our topic. Thank you so much.